Today, I'm going to show you everything you need to know to get started editing with the VN Video Editor all on your mobile phone. Let's jump in. So in order to get the app, just go to wherever you get your apps, in my case, the App Store. And you just want to search for VN Video Editor, and you'll see it there, and then you'll just download it from there. And then when you open it up, it'll bring you to your home screen like this. So step one is to start a new project. So you see right there in the middle of the screen is new project. Click on that. And we want to go to the video based. So we go save. And as long as you allow it access, it'll take you to a screen here that shows you the photos and videos that you have on your phone already. And then you just want to click on the videos that you want to use to add in there. So I'll just click on three to get started. And then you press the little arrow on the bottom right-hand corner to add those to the timeline. And step two, we're going to trim and split the clips to get them put together. So the first thing you need to know is you could drag your finger across the bottom and see the timeline as it runs across the screen. You can also pinch with your two fingers in on the screen to zoom into the timeline. So now we could see everything on the screen together. That didn't edit anything, that didn't change anything, but it just allows us to see everything together. All right, so we're looking at the whole timeline here. Let's go into one of the clips here. Some basics of the editing is we just want to scroll over and we want to trim this clip, so we don't want all of that video. You can see down at the bottom it says trim. We just click on that. And now we can find the exact point that we want to stop it. So right where I finished talking, so I'm going to bring in the right side and we'll clip that there. And then we could even bring in the beginning to where right before I start talking. Great. So now we trimmed off the end of the clip and the beginning of the clip, and you click OK. And so you could go through each of your clips and trim them that way. Another way to edit is with the split tool. So if we run across the timeline here and we say, maybe I want to take that clip and split it right when it starts coming back the other way. So we want to go right there. And now right below in the middle, you see split. You click on that. Now we took that one clip and we split it into two. That second clip, we don't want it all. We could just delete that. So we hit the little trash can, the delete button. It deletes it and it moves everything from the right over to it so that all the clips are there together. So a couple of ways to be able to edit your clips there. Step number four, I didn't want to delete that, so I want to undo that mistake. So you can see the little looped arrow there, and we just go undo, and it adds that clip back in there, and you go, oh no, maybe I did want to delete that. So then you just go redo, and it does that. So you can always correct your mistakes. There's nothing permanent in here that you're going to mess up. Step number five, we're going to add some transitions between our clips. So we got this clip here, and then it just cuts directly to that next clip. I want to add a transition in there, so I'm just going to tap on that plus sign between the two clips, and you can find some different elements you want. Let's say we want to do this dissolve. That's kind of a cool dissolve. You hit the check mark, and now you have that dissolve between the videos. You can hit your play button to watch that back, and it looks like that. Step number six, we want to add some music and voiceovers to this. So we're going to go up first, add some music. So we're going to tap on the music button, click on the music, and let's get some vlog music. And let's try this one. Let's use it. That sounds good. Now you can even dial that in more. You can add the volume or fade in, fade out, things like that. So I am going to add a little fade in. I'm going to add a little fade out. The volume's okay. And hit the check mark. And now we go back to the beginning and we've got some music. Now we could also add some sound effects. So I'm just going to click on that little music icon again, add sound effects. And let's say we want a fast switch. All right, we're going to use that. And we're just going to slide that over between those clips so that we have a little swoosh between the two clips. And we'll see what that sounds like here.
You're going to see when you sign up for my brand new vlog.
There you go. Okay, we're going to add a little transition there. Just going to do a dissolve that way. Let's see what that looks like. Very good. Now let's add a little voiceover. So when we start showing my shelf and my toy collection here, we're going to click on the audio again and click on record, allow it to use the microphone, tap record, And we're going to go, here's a look at all of my collection of Batman and other comic book memorabilia. Enjoy. And stop. Click the check mark. And now you have this voiceover, which sounds like this. Here's a look at all of my collection of Batman and other comic book memorabilia. Enjoy. So you can see, you can just keep layering in the audio, layering in the video, and making it really pop. Which brings us to step number 7. Let's add some text. So we're going to go over here to the scroll of my desk here. Right below the music icon, there is the text. Click on that. We're going to add a title. You could scroll through here, find the one that you like the best. I like some of these presets. Maybe I want to try that one. And then we're going to tap in the box. We're going to change the text from vlog 1 to go my desk. Click OK. Now you can kind of adjust the size, make it bigger. This is where it'll ultimately land. And then preview that back. It looks like that. So that's how you add text in there. Now let's say as we scroll across the desk here, I want to overlay another picture in there, a graphic or image or whatever you want. What we're going to do, you see the track for an overlay. We're just going to click on that. We're going to find elements. And let's go across here and let's add the TikTok logo and we'll just move that right over the screen that way. And it even gives you guidelines here so you can see when you're centered. Let's say we want to add that there. Line that up so it goes the whole length of that screen there. And again, we go back, we preview that. We have that sticker come up on the screen and that could be your own picture, your own graphic, your logo, whatever you want there to add in that way. And then I also noticed here as this video trails off that the video, my video drops off. I don't want to include that. So I'm just going to get to this very end here, tap on the video, grab that little arrow again and slide it over. Now we've trimmed the end of that. And step number 9 is to crop the video so that it fits what the format is that you want it to fit in. And then let's say we want to crop in some images here. So let's say I don't want all that headspace with my ceiling showing. So we can click on that video and then we're just going to scroll across the bottom and click on the crop. And across the bottom, it has some of those presets. Let's say we want to keep it for TikTok. And now when I bring that down, it'll keep that aspect ratio the same. And we'll just crop that down like that. And then I can touch my image here and kind of frame it up exactly how I want it like that. Okay. And then again, you hit that check mark. And now we've cropped that image in a little bit better. Step number 10, we're going to change the aspect ratio of the entire video. So if you go up to the top, you go to the original, which means that it's just exactly the format that the videos came in at. And you could change that to 9x16 for TikTok or go to Instagram or 16x9, whatever you want in there. We're going to go to TikTok and we're going to click OK. And now it's changed that aspect ratio, which is very similar to what I already had it, into what the preset needs to be for TikTok. And once you preview that back and everything looks the way you want it, step number 12 is to export that video. So we're just going to go up here to the top where it says that blue icon with the arrow pointing up. Click on that. You can then decide if you want to use the auto settings, which I typically find are the best, and just click on export. It'll take a few seconds to export it. It'll save it back onto the camera roll of your phone. And then it's yours to do what you want. Post it on TikTok, post it on Instagram, share it with friends, whatever you like. And that, my friends, is how you use VN Video Editor all on your phone. Enjoy.